I promise.
As long as the good people home know what's going on. This is Grand Finals. We got Samus versus Falco. Chevy coming from losers. Who was Chevy's first loss to? You know? Okay, so this is the run back. Let's see if Chevy can do this. Chevy recently, you know, getting on the PR. Let's see if he can show us all why he's ranked top 10 in the state, and Jawanga's not. Alright, so Falco's gotta be really careful in this matchup. Now, Falco's trying to lock down Samus with lasers and stuff, and trying. Do anything dumb on shield that can get outbeat, or get grabbed and gimped, or anything like that. Now, Falco's gotta play a very patient game.
Ready?
test. All right, cool, we're back. But Chevy take... Oh, I missed that first stock, unfortunately, but Chevy takes it. Doesn't have a huge amount of percent on him. And now that Chevy has the lead, he can... He doesn't have to approach. He doesn't have that pressure on him. He can rely a lot more on using anti-approach options. So let's see what Jawanga can do against the wall. Good defensive play by Chevy. Good spot dodge to avoid a nair earlier, and then a good roll away for further follow-ups. Try to catch a Falco with that up smash. Looks like Falco crouch cancel it, or maybe the up smash is actually just that weak. Sorry? Score is 1-0, Jawanga. Ooh, that was interesting. Reverse up tilt in the back air. Let's go. Ooh, into edge hog. Okay, nice. So Chevy's gonna go up a sock again. Let's see what how Jawanga responds. Alright, recovers above that nair, so he's safe. He's trying to wall out Samus, keep her off stage. Ooh, that laser was nice, but he's not going to seal the deal. That down smash not quite reaching far enough. Chevy makes it back on. And getting on some straight hits, you know, a fair here, an upbeat there. He's going to take all the percent he can get. Chevy trying to recover here. Yep, he gets back to ledge. Please, you want to commentate with me? I'm good, thank you. It's melee. I mean, I can't commentate anything, but I'm still doing it. Just commentate this match instead of the PM, and then criticize them for not using PM specific options. Super wave dashing is a thing in melee.
I know, but it's harder.
Dude, that's that movement option ever. Yeah, you gotta use those movement options. You gotta use those movement mix-ups.
Or else it's lit.
Ooh, let's go.
Yeah, he could have strung that in all double super wave dash. Ooh, that was nice.
Oh, what a medium. Well, that was... He did the downward and down tilt. Okay, the fourth tilt.
It's frame perfect in melee and 2 frames in piano protocol.
Tomo, do you wanna chip it too? Do you wanna...
Okay, famous Amos.
You ready for
some
PM?
Dude, I still haven't played in PM. I think I've only played in melee.
I don't think I've ever played.
Yeah, I've played in PM.
Luigi, Mario, and Snapman.
Yeah, you kind of bought me if I recall. What?
Ready?
I did? Okay, I could have. You play Lucario in PM, yeah? In theory, I have matchup experience against Lucario because I used to play with IPK. But that was a long time ago. So I started off as a SoCal PM player. Like all of 2014, I didn't play Melee, I was a SoCal PM player. This was back in 3.0 and then like a few months into 3.0.
Was the balcony a video game?
Balcony wasn't a thing back then.
Oh, what is
it? No, balcony is, I believe, a post 3.6 convention, but I'm not 100% sure. Because the party and Zesty weren't part of the community back when I was playing. They joined more recently, and they're the TOs for balcony.
Chevy,
yeah, Chevy went game 2.
He was up like...
He was up the whole game. But then I stopped paying attention to talk about PM.
Bells was so crisp at like the first stock.
SoCal PM is pretty dang good. What do you think of this Aki Jose V beef?
I Oh, that's so crazy.
Aki got drunk on some chat and called Bellevue the fuck out. Dude, Aki. Yes, so Aki got drunk and was on some semi-IM channel, I don't know what chat it was, but he was shocking shit about Jose, about how SoCal just like really sucks at the best matchup, and Jose V goes for stuff that like doesn't work at all. Dude, smashing that crap is hard. Like, that's like people saying you shouldn't get hit by up throw up air by Fox in Melee. Like, yeah, you can just smash DI it,
but it's hard.
Yeah, this is in fact a sport. There are technical barriers. Is SDI any easier than PM than Melee? I, like, don't know, like... Same, okay. So is this Sonic like really unique compared to, you know, like Aeon?
Yeah. He's much more sight.
Rascally?
Yeah, R-A-S. CL, it does not ask me to have the word rascal. He loves losing.
That explains so much.
That's why you play Luigi.
He double eliminated me last week.
Oh no! Ripped Jawanga.
Last week was my return to PM, and my return to PM Sonic apparently.
I don't think Jawanga can make it back to PM Sonic, because Chevy's just attacking.
Ooh, whoa, Chevy!
Oh,
is
what a
hell I got, dude. The Jawanga has an entire set to leave that. Like, this is the reset. Oh, this is going for the reset, sorry. Yeah, no, I quit end of 2014, and then I played one PM tournament at a Super Smash Nest in Oregon, like, back in the summer.
Are you gonna go to Smash and Stigma?
Probably.
Think you can run?
Yeah, probably.
I'm going. I wanna help raise the funds.
I mostly, like, haven't been going to PM only tournaments, but, like, this one seems like a pretty big deal.
Yeah.
I don't know, the Washington PM community seems super nice. So, like, yeah, chill.
My first time meeting you.
Nice to meet you, man. What's your name?
Hapster.
Hapster?
Yeah.
I'm Leo. I'm Xander and PM and Pride in Melee. Our pride in most things that aren't PM. But.
Jawanga off to a really nice start. Oh, you should probably.
Who said the what?
I'll do it then.
Game one. Both sides are 100%. Let's see what Jawanga can do to adapt to Chevy. Apparently the round is grand finals. Dot dot dot. Alright, Chevy takes the first stock. Let's see if Jawanga can close out this. Samus is a really high percent, but I don't know how much that actually matters. Imagine the extent that, you know, a random stray aerial from Falco might kill. You know, a random weak air is usually not that big a deal, but now it probably is. And as I say that, so again. So, this entire system is... Your boy Zeddy is getting real hype in the chat for Chevy.
That's good.
Yeah.
It's your boy Zeddy.
Your boy Zeddy is in fact Zeddy.
Yes.
Confirmed.
I know, I know. Had that up just in the
air. Goes for the down throw. A lot of spaces like going for down throw against Samus. Yeah, I agree with you. I agree with you. So a lot of spaces like going for down throw at high percent because they can kill off a read on the tech chase.
But it's so hard to get that read.
It's so hard to get that read. Like, you can't... It's really not a reaction tech chase situation. Like, especially for a character...
It's so fast for most characters. But if it's a really obvious roll, if it's, like, really obvious for the roll, then it's good to go for the down throw.
Yeah.
But if he's gonna... If it's in the middle of the stage...
Thank you. Stock. Let's see if Jawanga can carry this momentum to take a turning. Nice aerials by Chevy. Jawanga makes it back. Next with side B, unfortunately. Ooh, right into the missile. And Chevy takes that stock. Go back to the tie game. Let's see what Chevy can do to keep his momentum here. Gets the grab. No conversion, unfortunately. Again, that grab is super duper hard. You really want to get as milk for as much as you can, because it's frankly not very safe. It's really slow. You know, in terms of the frame data, if you look at the frames, you're gonna come to the conclusion that you should be able to react to that every time. In practice, that's not really what happens. You know, the Samuses will, pardon my means, but he will try to condition you into, you know, missing that reaction, or into doing something with punishable that can get grabbed. Laser S smash, let's go. You know, it's a close game, but Jawanga's been like a little bit ahead for most of it. So let's see what he can do to keep this up. But Chevy's trying to wall him out. Ooh, nice up tilt. Off stage, yeah, can't recover from that. Stock is very fragile. We're gonna go to last stock. Down throw for again who knows what reason. It's a 26%. I really don't know why you're going for down throw. You know, up throw gets you vertical position. Forward throw gets you some, you know, horizontal position. Down throw is... I mean, it did cause Sherry to tech into the corner, which I guess that's nice. Perhaps that makes it better than forward throw in that situation. But I mean, you're kind of guessing as to, like, how you can follow up. I don't know. I see the rationale, but it's kind of sketchy. Falco has a hard time just, like, direct cover to counter those rolls. Laser edge guards are very interesting with Jawanga. Should be a really tough time. Chevy's trying to bomb navigate around them as well as he can. Ooh, just makes it back. Can Chevy close out this game? He's 100% down. But right, Chevy on ledge, fighting for his life. Jawanga just being really patient with lasers and mostly not giving in until he did and got punished. But, you know, he's still looking pretty good. We're just gonna take one good conversion by Chevy to, like, take this. Ooh, oh, that could have been it. He could have just down smashed that mistech, but no. Oh, but he takes the stock anyway. Chevy's gonna take that game. We're gonna game 3, 1-1. You wanna commentate with me? Alright, Jawanga's taking us to Yoshi's. That's an interesting pick. Not quite what I expected, given that his strategy's been relying a lot on controlling space and keeping Chevy out with these lasers. Yoshi's is gonna, you know, encourage a lot more close combat, which is exactly what Chevy wants. So, it's an interesting position. I guess, you know, Yoshi's is nice because it's got the really small ceiling, so there's gimps off the top, and it's got really small boundaries, so it's gonna be a lot easier for Jawanga to kill. That's a problem he did have last game, although Fountain's boundaries are pretty small as it is, but not nearly as small as Yoshi's. Chevy, though, gets that nice top platform up the outer shield, and also gets a nice missile platform to work with. So, we'll see how this counter break affects this matchup. We got a pretty even game right now. Ooh, that upper is gonna kill off the top. Yoshi's doing his job at the moment. Yes, Yoshi's ledge is also really nice for spaces, and it looks like Jawanga has some of that technology that a lot of spaces don't, but could be abusing. So that side platform on Yoshi's is really good for spaces and invincible wave cuts. Like, obviously they got ledge dash like they do on every other stage, but you can do an invincible hack dash off of that platform. You can do a platform waveline hack dash at spaces, fully invincible, which is crazy. Plus you could do, you know, a ledge hop, platform wing land off back air, and that's completely invincible. So you got like extra invincible options, and you control when you're on ledge, you threaten a lot more space on Yoshi's than you would on another stage. And Chevy has to respect that, as Jawanga's forced Chevy to respect that. Against a lot of spaces, you don't really need to respect that, because a lot of spaces, I mean, hell, a lot of spaces just get scared to do regular ledge dashes, but yeah, usually the spacey is just bad, and you don't want to respect it. But like, if the spacey knows what's up and has his ledge technology, you gotta like just give up stage, and it's scary. So Let's see how Jawanga did. Jawanga's down to stock. But takes it back with that back air. Nice. Xander, the next in front.
Oh.
It actually like was correct. Like Pride is also my tag. But that's fine.
We can switch it when PM comes on.
Kickapoo is on the mic with me now.
Yeah.
How's it going?
Pretty good, buddy. Alright, so yeah, you were saying that Jawanga's main tech has been to control space using the lasers and just kind of keep Samus out.
You know, that's an interesting recovery Chevy does a lot. He'll go for that tether above stage to poke with his air, and, you know, he gets that weird Z-jump. I don't know what the mechanic behind that is, but he gets that weird jump off it.
Yeah, I don't know the specifics behind it, but that's a thing that happens to him as well. Yeah, he gets, like, a lot more momentum upwards, or in the direction that he's air dodging before he finishes the tether.
They're now 1-1 in sets for the tournament. Chevy's up this set. Falco goes to FD. A much more expected choice from Yoshi's, I think. Samus kind of suffers without platforms.
Yeah.
Because, like, her air movement is, like... I mean, it's shit. It
yeah.
just, like, really sucks.
Yeah.
And he doesn't have those missiles for the platform cancel missiles.
Yeah, I was going to say. His missile pressure is definitely going to be missing. But with, like, I don't know, I think with better spacing, if you notice he's, like, outspacing Jawanga on a lot of his stuff, he's calling him out on a lot of things and stuff in his recovery, or his approaches, and I think, like, this is a fine choice.
What's up?
Oof.
Are you the Ivysaur player?
He is okay. The Ivysaur player.
Sounds good. Someone, tell me the Ivysaur matchup real quick.
Who do you play?
Okay. So I like do kind of know this matchup because I used to play Machiavelli, and I like, but back then like I was like playing Broken Lucas, so like it doesn't really count.
Yeah.
Cause like back then I could just force Machiavelli onto Falco because the Ivy was obviously like not difficult.
Mm-hmm.
But now it's a new game. We'll see. I guess like you know I'm playing Marth, right? So
Marth.
Probably just like outspace all his crap and juggle him.
Yeah. Yeah. You just.
What does Marth do against these tether recoveries? Can I just like ledge hop near those?
To a certain degree. You can, I'd rather just like hold stage and wait to see what he does. You can, when he reels in his tether, you can hop there and then you cover basically anything that he wants to go for. Or you could go for Sour Spot out there, and if he's DI'ing away to get back to the ledge, you can put his hands at it. It's basically what
okay, sounds good.
Anyways, back to this match.
Yeah, back to this match. Chevy looking to, oh, Chevy does take that stop.
Yeah.
Nice.
Just barely, though.
Yeah, just barely, even at 166.
That was good DI on Dwight. He was even coming down. And he managed to DI on the right time.
Jawanga getting some nice damage on.
Ooh. That's gonna cost
that aerial interrupt down smash was kind of greedy. And costing the stock. Let's see how Chevy adapts. Ooh, this is a cool string. Let's go.
Ooh,
that jab was nice. Unfortunately, couldn't follow up off it, but that was really good. Nice 58% right there.
Yeah,
wave dash forward, F-tilt, wave dash forward, F-tilt, wave dash forward, grab. Let's go.
That's what I was saying with, like, now that it's a flat platform, like, he loses the multiple platforms that he can move on pretty quick and get that going. But, like, Falco also loses that. And whenever he's jumping around, like, it's going to be a lot more obvious when he's going to come down. Like, Falco loses a lot of movement options, in my opinion, as well.
Yeah, that's definitely true.
It is definitely hurting him.
It does look like Chevy's been dropping a lot of... Well, he got that power shield right there, but it looks like he has been, like, dropping a lot of, like, common reactions against Falco, like, especially against the side B recovery and power shielding these lasers.
Yeah.
I know Chevy is, like, known to have a sketchy reaction time, so I wonder if that affects his performance in this matchup. Because Falco is a matchup where there's, like, a lot of stuff that just gets so much easier to have those reactions.
Yeah.
Like that forward tilt earlier where he tried to catch the side B, I mean, like, if he had gotten that, like, this game would be looking very different. It's really amazing, like, mainly, like, one mistake would make the entire game look very different.
That's a lot of fighting games. Yeah, I mean, there's a what, like... Yeah. I was gonna start talking about another fighting game, and I was like, ah!
No, but I mean, you're absolutely right. Some punish games are certainly more punishing than others.
Yeah. And like, Samus has the unfortunate, like, luckily in this matchup, he can use it a whole lot more, but, like, Samus can keep players in the field a lot. It's pretty safe against Samus because the grab is really obvious when it comes out. It's hard to get a general follow-up on Samus unless you're paying attention to, like, certain percentages and their DI and yada yada. Yeah, but luckily it's a spacey, so he can just out-throw and get it for free.
Ooh, that was a sick charge shot.
Damn, Chevy.
That was a crazy conversion.
That was crazy good.
Chevy's showing us stuff none of us have ever seen before.
Huge fan. I'm a huge fan of jabbing aerial bows. Like, it's such great tech. I love it.
Falco's at 0%. Samus has a lot of percent on her. Probably can't crouch cancel as much shit at this percent.
Yeah.
Ooh, Jawanga getting right up in the face with those lasers and jabs. That upper's not quite going to kill. This isn't Yoshi's anymore, fellas. Or an FD. Cover. Ooh, that bear hits!
Oh,
and
yeah.
Okay, he's living. Chevy is living. Let's go.
I'm beating Chevy. Forgot about that.
Jawanga really needs this game. He's got to take it to game 5. Show us what's what. Chevy's fighting for his FD life.
He's one good thing that I've noticed is he's really not overextending on the edge. He's just sitting there throwing out aerials. He's not trying to, like, get down there, toss out down airs that can, like, potentially be game winners, but also, you know, he's on final stock. He's got to watch it.
Yeah, he really wants Jawanga to do something now. He's really waiting for that. But Jawanga's also playing super duper good. He's playing really patient. He's not letting himself get into really bad situations, which, like, you know, Scrubby Falco syndrome is... You are always in really bad situations. But Jawanga's no Scrubby Falco.
Plus, this is it. I mean, like, this will be final game if Chevy takes it, so he's got to play really patient. And he's doing, like, a great job. That's what I'm saying right here.
Oh, Chevy goofs.
Oh, okay.
Chevy derps. And it's going to game 5. We're 2-2. They're 1-1 in sets. Let's go. Let's see if Jawanga can pull off a crazy upset.
That would be nice. Well, I mean... It would be like Chevy getting the upset. I mean, Jawanga knocked him into the losers. But yeah, like, Chevy now on the PR.
Chevy's the ranked player here, you know.
Yeah.
Is, he's the only ranked player in this tournament, right?
Yes. Yeah, he's the only one. Ooh, a phantom horse. All right.
Nice up out of shield by Chevy, getting those missiles started versus getting those lasers started. Let's see. Ooh, nice pressure by Jawanga, those cross-ups. Let him get some nice damage in.
He's still
facing around it after.
Really patient. I like that. I like seeing patient Falco. Like,
using shine the way it was intended to be used.
Yeah. And, like, lasering. Like, you really don't have to go in against players. Like, you can sit back and laser, and, like, a lot of people are like, man, you're just camping. Oh, man. Like, that's really annoying. It's like, well, unless you can do something about it, I'm going to keep doing it.
Yeah. And it's certainly not an unbeatable strategy, but, you know, Chevy's power shields have not been on point, and if your power shields are not on point, it's a pretty difficult strategy.
Yeah.
Especially when you don't have air mobility to just, like, jump over those lasers.
Yeah.
Like, Sam is going to try jumping over them, it's just, like, not going to work. She's going to stay in the same place, but she has no air mobility whatsoever.
And outside of, like, and because lasers will, like, stuff grounded approaches, Chevy's aerial approach is, what, like, a lazy nair coming down on him,
yeah,
hoping that he
like
doesn't
that.
Do anything about it?
Like... There really isn't anything good he can do as an aerial approach. But he got the hedgehog, and now it's back to an even game, but Jawanga is racking up the percent. Ooh! Stadium has a low ceiling, guys. Stadium's got the second lowest ceiling in the game. So that's gonna be good for Jawanga. What do you think of the stage pick? Because Chevy took Jawanga to Stadium. Which, the platforms are nice, but the transformations are not nice, and I would assume the size of the stage is not nice.
Yeah.
This is game five, man.
Not really sure. I think he was looking for more, like, actually catching him as he tethers in. Really, Bubs.
All right. We can no longer see because a cable got unplugged, but I'm sure the game is very good right now. All right, we're back. Chevy's down in stock.
It's all right. I think he was trying to get a little bit more pressure started. Chevy is trying to get a little bit more pressure with his missiles, but he really hasn't, like, found the time to do it. Jawanga's been really consistent with his lasers and kind of putting them in a way. He's been, like, jumping up high as well, using the full hop lasers when he gets a good distance and he's, like, near a platform to make sure that Chevy can't just hop up to the first platform, start the missile spam, and, just follow up on that.
You know, that's interesting. It looks like Samus' dash attack puts her hurtbox low enough that she can actually dash attack below Falco's Nair. Because Falco's Nair also raises his leg up.
Yeah.
So you saw that interact.